Hey YouTube, welcome to Brennan's Tech Byte, and today I have Apple's AirPort Express. This device allows you to stream your music wirelessly from your computer to any speaker or stereo system in your home. It also allows you to print wirelessly, extend your Wi-Fi range, and also share your wireless network with up to 10 users. This device looks like a really large plug. It has a 3.5mm jack, a USB port, and also an Ethernet port. And today I have a demo on how to set up AirTunes with Apple's AirPort Express, and also how to control your music with your iPod, iPhone, or iPad. So let's get started then. Start by grabbing a mini stereo to RCA cable. Plug in the mini stereo cable into the AirPort Express's 3.5mm jack, and then plug in the device into your wall outlet. Next, plug in the white and red RCA cables into your stereo. Make sure you plug these cables into the auxiliary in inputs. Also make sure the volume is up and the stereo is on the AUX setting. If you are plugging in speakers, just plug in the 3.5mm headphone jack directly into the Apple AirPort Express. Now go to your computer and make sure you enable AirTunes. To check, launch AirPort Utility. Double click on your AirPort Express. Select the iTunes icon and make sure Enabled AirTunes is checked. Also check the status light on the AirPort Express. It should be green. When you initially plug it in, the light is yellow, but it turns green within a few minutes. Now launch iTunes and download the remote application by Apple. This application will allow you to control your whole iTunes library from your iPod Touch, iPhone, or iPad. It's a free application, so to download, just click free app to install. To find it in the App Store, just type in Apple Remote. Once it's done downloading, sync it to your iPod Touch, iPad, or iPhone. And then launch the application in your device. Click on Add Library, and it gives you a 4-digit passcode. You're gonna have to type this passcode into your iTunes library to pair your device. So go to your iTunes library, and under Devices, click on the title of your device, and then type in that corresponding passcode. And then type it in one more time. And then it says your device is now ready. Real quick, one thing I forgot to mention was make sure you have iTunes open on your computer when you run AirTunes. So right now, here's my setup. I have my AirPort Express right here, my stereo system, and then my laptop. And here's my iPad, which I'll be controlling my whole iTunes library from. Remember, I said that you can use both your iPad, your iPod Touch, and also your iPhone. So to begin, just launch the remote application. And then you can view everything you can on your iTunes library, such as Genius Mixes, Playlists, Browse by Artists. You can search for a particular song, artist, or album. If you hit more, you can view your albums, by music by genre, movies, music videos, podcasts, songs, and TV shows. So let me show you the controls real quick. You have your play and pause right here. Sorry, I can't play the audio for you because of copyright infringement. And you can also skip to another song. You have your volume control right here. And also, if you tap the screen, you can scrub the track, can create a genius mix, shuffle the songs, and if you hit speakers, you can select which speakers you want your music to play out of. If you just want to play out your AirPort Express, just have that checked. Or if you want to play out your computer, just have your computer checked. And you can also have them both play out of both your computer and AirPort Express. So it's pretty cool and it's really easy and fun to use.
So that's a quick look at AirTunes on AirPort Express. Having an AirPort Express makes listening to music enjoyable and also effortless. To get one of these, it costs $99 at the Apple Store and also $99 at Apple.com. If you want to get one a little bit cheaper, you can get one on eBay, ranging from $50 to $80. And if you want some more information, you can go to www.apple.com/AirPort Express. And also, if you want me to make some more tutorials on the other features of this device, just leave me a comment in the section below. So that wraps it up for today. Thanks for tuning in, and please subscribe so you can stay up to date with my latest videos and also to be entered in my giveaways. So I'll see you next time on Brennan's Tech Bite.